This video is going to be a little bit drier than most of my videos because it's going to be based on subjective data. I was finally able to make it out to the range and do kind of an apples to oranges comparison. It's not the best comparison by any means, but I wanted to see shooting my pistol standards test that I made for myself. What is faster and more accurate, a red dot pistol or a iron-sided pistol? Again, this is not going to be the best comparison because I have a 9mm 1911 with a red dot versus an iron-sided 45. So obviously a much more accurate comparison would be if I had two of the same gun, exact same gun, one iron-sided, one with a red dot. I do have a Gen 5 Glock 19 that is iron-sided and a Gen 4 Glock 19 that has an RMR on it, and I will get those out there at some point in time because I think that'd be a much more fair comparison. But nevertheless, today I was able to shoot these two kind of in a head-to-head to see which is better. I just got to the range a little bit ago, and I shot this cold. Hadn't shot all day today. I shot the 45 1911 from Wilson first, and then I shot the RMR. For those of you not familiar, my pistol standards test is fairly simple. I start at 3 yards, and I will fire two rounds to the body. So the buzzer will go off, I'll draw from the holster, and I will shoot two rounds at 3 yards, 5 yards, 7 yards, 10, 15, and 25. After I shoot two to the body, which they have to be in this box, if they're out, they don't count, I will do the exact same yard lines and fire one single shot to the head from the holster, okay? I record my hits and my times, and then I did the exact same thing with the other gun, of course. Once again, I did fire this first, okay? So just right off the bat, for the sake of brevity, you will see that I had I shot 10 out of 12 to the body. I had two out, which is actually extremely embarrassing because one of them was at 7 yards. And it should be noted that these were follow-up shots with the red dot. The first shots were in the box. The second subsequent shot was outside the box at 7 and 15 yards. And that's just due to me not tracking my red dot and breaking my shot too soon. I hadn't allowed my gun to fully settle. So that's, I guess, my excuse on that. Nevertheless, I wanted to shoot this honestly and not recock it. So I did have two misses with the EDC X9. All right, so 10 out of 12, that is a hit percent of 83%. That is the average hit percentage. Then I took all my times for the body, and I came up with a 2.81 average. Did the same thing for the head. I had 100%. There should be 6 shots in the head, and there are. I had 100% accuracy with the EDC X9 with the red dot, and an average time of 1.93. That is the average time if you take all those and divide them by 6. Wilson Combat 1911 CQB and 45, same exact thing. I had one outside at 15 yards and one outside at 25 yards. Again, I could run this a billion different times and take the results, probably run it clean sometimes, probably have more or less misses, but again, this is what I ran first time through, and that's what I was gonna stick with. So we get the exact same accuracy percentage. So I had 10 out of 12 hits, and then I had an average time of 2.54. 2.54. So for the body, this is the interesting thing. For the body hits with the 1911, the iron sided pistol was faster than the red dot pistol. Average time. The hit percentage on the head, once again, I did have 6 hits. I barely squeaked the one at 25, but that is in the box. I had 100% accuracy rate with my headshots, and then an average of 2.06. That was my average time for that. Whereas if you look at my red dotted pistol, 1.93 was the average. So while this was faster for the body shots, this was faster for the head shots. And I have the exact same accuracy percentages, which is kind of interesting. Now, there is a tendency, and the reason I bring this video up is because there's a lot of argument which is faster, you know, red dots or iron sights, okay? A lot of people claim that red dotted pistols are slower up close, yada, yada, yada. I mean, I, like everyone else who's been shooting, have a lot more time with an iron sighted pistol than a red dot, but I am no stranger to red dot pistols by any means. I've been shooting them for a couple years now, and I really like them. I'm a big fan of red dots. So you'll see that it is hard to declare an absolute winner. While this was faster with the body shots, this was faster with the headshots, had the exact same accuracy percentage, and I don't know, just kind of interesting. Now, I will say there is a tendency, for those of you who shot red dots, you kind of know what I'm talking about. There is a tendency to demand a higher degree of accuracy with your red dot. For anybody who's picked up a red dot pistol, you know that your movement, your shaking or whatever you want to call it, is a lot more pronounced and noticeable when you're shooting a red dot pistol. It's more magnified. You do the exact same thing with an iron sighted pistol. It's just you don't pick it up as easily, right? You don't notice it as much. So I would argue, and a lot other people that are much smarter than me and have a lot more experience with red dots have said the same thing. There's a tendency to, I guess, demand more of your sight picture with a red dot to try and take a more precise shot because everything is more pronounced. So I hope that makes sense. Whereas with iron sighted guns, it's not as noticeable. So you'll give yourself a lot more, leeway, leniency. You don't notice it as much. So I hope I explained that fairly well. So this isn't meant to really prove anything. This was just meant to kind of showcase my results on this given day, which today is October 8th, 2019. And I just wanted to see what I could do. A close-up of my shots with the 1911, and these are the close-up of my shots with the EDC X9. Again, you could run this a bunch of different times and probably get different results, but these are my results today shooting it cold. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you have any questions or comments, please comment below. Thanks for watching.